So today our topic is to discuss the combination of resistors. Okay, resistance is nothing but a ratio of potential difference to the electric current flowing through that current to that conductor, and its units is ohms. Everybody knows. And resistivity is nothing but rho equal to rho l by a. From that, rho equal to ra by l. And next one, conductivity is the reciprocal of the resistivity. Okay, reciprocal of resistivity means conductivity is mentioned with sigma, and sigma equal to 1 by rho. Rho is the resistivity. The reciprocal of resistivity gives the conductivity. And also in yesterday's class we are discussing conductivity, superconductivity. Okay, and today we are discussing the combination of resistors. Okay, the resistors can be arranged in two ways: series combination and the parallel combination. So in series combination, the resistors will be connected in this way. Okay, R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, and so on. How many resistors are connected here? 3 resistors are connected in series. Okay, this is the point A, terminal point, and this is the terminal point B. In these two terminal points, the 3 resistors are connected in this way. This type of combination is nothing but a series combination of the resistors. In series combination, our resultant resistance capital R will be equal to the sum of the individual resistance. Okay, R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. For example, R1 equal to 2 ohms, R2 equal to 3 ohms, R3 equal to 5 ohms. Then our resultant resistance R equal, the total resistance R equal 2 plus 3 plus 4. That will be equal to R equal to 11 ohms. 2 plus 3 plus 4. So 5 plus 4, 9. So the effective resistance is equal to the sum of the individual resistances. In series combination, the effective resistance will be equal to the sum of the individual resistance in a series combination. Next, current through each resistor is same. In series combination, the current is same. It is flowing on each resistor. That means I will be same in each resistor. Okay, the current is same in series combination. Sum of the potential differences across individual resistors is equal to the sum of the potential differences of individual resistors will be equal to the potential difference applied by the source. Okay, sum of the individual, that means V equal to whatever it is. V is the potential difference applied. That will be equal to the potential, sum of the individual potential differences, V1 plus V2 plus V3 onward. So combination of resistors, in this we are mentioned the 3 resistors are connected in series. So the combination can be expressed by using the diagram. A and B are the 2 terminal points, okay, starting point and the ending point. And in between these 2 points, the 3 resistors are connected in this way. That combination is nothing but a series combination. Okay, in series combination, the effective resistance will be equal to the sum of the individual resistance. We are taking n resistors, then the effective resistance R will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus and so on Rn. Okay, so the current flowing through these 3 resistors will be same. Okay, and the sum of the potential differences across their resistors will be equal to the potential difference applied by the source. So that potential difference we are applying, that source will be V. So the potential differences across these resistors is V1, V2, V3. Then V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. This is the series combination. And next one is in parallel combination, we are connecting the resistors. Looks like this parallel combination 1 1 1, R1 R2 R3. This combination, this type of crossing is nothing but a parallel combination of the resistors. Okay, in parallel combination, the reciprocal of the effective resistance will be equal to the reciprocals of the sum of the individual resistances. That means 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay, this is the reciprocal. R equal to natural value, 1 by R is the reciprocal of R. So in this parallel combination, the effective resistance will be equal to the, that means reciprocal of the effective resistance will be equal to the sum of the reciprocals of the individual resistances. Okay, that's it. That is 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay, next, potential difference across each resistor is same. In series combination, the current is same in each resistor, but in parallel combination, the potential difference is same in each resistor. Okay, potential difference across each resistor is same. Next, sum of electric current flowing through individual resistors is equal to the electric current drawn from the source. Okay, in this combination, the sum of the electric current flowing through each resistor will be equal to the current drawn from the source. That means here the combination is I equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Okay, got it? This is the difference. Once I will repeat it. Today we are discussing the combination of resistors. The combination of resistors observed, we have two types of combinations, in series combination and in parallel combination. In series combination, the resistors are connected in this way. Okay, here we are taking three resistors R1, R2 and R3, and A and B are the sources, terminal points. Okay, in the series combination, the effective resistance capital R will be equal to the sum of the individual resistances R1, R2 and the R3, R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. But in series combination, the current flowing through these resistors will be same. But the potential difference across these three resistors will be that means the sum of the potential differences across these three resistors will be equal to the potential difference across the source, potential difference applied by the source, that means V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. In parallel combination, we are observing that the three resistors are connected in parallel combination is like this way. So, in this combination, the effective resistance, that means the reciprocal, here R is the effective resistance. So, the reciprocal of the effective resistance will be equal to the reciprocals of the sum of the individual resistance in parallel combination. That means 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. In parallel combination, the current, so the potential difference across resistor is same. In series combination, the current across the connector is same. In this, potential differences across the three resistors will be same. Here, the effective current will be equal to the sum of the individual currents. So, the sum of the individual currents flowing in resistors will be equal to the current drawn by the source. That means I equal to I is the current drawn by the source, and I1 plus I2 plus I3 are the sum of the currents at resistors R1, R2 and R3. This is our combination of resistors. Okay. Next we will discuss the cell combination.